Okay, good afternoon. Today, you know, in this video, I am going to explain you all what, why is WTO and its objectives. Objectives of WTO. Objectives of WTO. I am going to explain you. Now, first, what is WTO? Okay. WTO is full name is World Trade Organizations. Okay, it is a one of the global institutions. Global organizations. It is one of the international organizations, which is usually organized to facilitate trade all over the world. So that all the country of the nations they can have trade between one country and another country without any obstacle, without any difficulties. Okay. World Trade Organization is the international organization which deals with global rules of trade between nations. Its main objective is to achieve economic prosperity through fair and free trade. It was established in January 1955. The main root of WTO is GATT, General Agreement on Trade and Tariffs. It was established in 1947 with a view to liberalize and expand the world trade. Now I said that this WTO is already have said that it is World Trade Organizations or it is one of the international organizations. Okay, and its main objective was to bring economic prosperity all over the world through fair and free trade, and it was established January 1995, and it got established from GATT. Before WTO, there was another organization which was named as GATT, means General Agreement on Trade and Tariffs. So after that, GATT got modified and it became what? WTO. Okay. The headquarters of WTO is located at Geneva, Switzerland. At present, there are more than 164 member countries of WTO. Nepal is 147 member and got WTO membership on April 23, 2004. So it is said that when they got headquarters of WTO, it is in Switzerland, Geneva. And at present, there are more than 148 member countries. And Nepal is also one of its member country. And Nepal has become 147 members and has got membership of WTO on April 23, 2004. So Nepal's membership of WTO is very important for its economic development and integration into the multilateral trading systems. So it will help Nepal for country-wise and community-wise trade diversification. It said that Nepal to diversify trades have a multilateral trade, bilateral trade for Nepal is very important to be the member of this one, WTO. Without being member of WTO, Nepal cannot diversify its trade or cannot expand its international trade, cannot expand its import and exports. Okay, now objectives of WTO. Objective is what? WTO. Okay, number one, rising living standard of peoples. Rising standard of living and optimal utilization of standard of living and income, promoting full employment, expanding production and trade, and optimal utilization of world resources. So number one point is that to raise the living standard of people. So to raise the living standard of people, this WTO, what means? It has focus on increasing the people incomes. It has focus on full employment opportunity. It has focus on increasing productions. It has focused on what? Increasing trades. And it has focused on optimal utilization of natural resources. So when there is optimal utilization of natural resources, what happens? Production of the country can be increased. And when there is more production, what happens? It can be exported to other countries. There will be trade. Plus, when there is proper utilization of resources, what happens? More industrial factory will be utilized. And many people also will get job. So income of the people will increase in this advance. People living standard will increase. So that is the one objective of, or the main objective of this work, WTO, or the sustainable development. Introducing sustainable development, a concept wise, anyways, that development and environment can go together. Now next thing is that focusing on sustainable development. So what is sustainable development? Is it that the resources available in the nature, they also will be utilized, you know, and they also will be development, and they also will be what? Environment conservations. And they also increase the production of the nations, and that also increase the income of the nations. Better share of growth in trade. Better share of growth in trade. Taking positive steps to ensure that developing countries, especially the least developed countries, secure a better share of growth in trade. So, number three objective is that especially to facilitate the, you know, developing and least developed country. So those countries which come under, you know, least developed country or developing countries. Now to also, you know, make them, you know, enlarge their trade, to diversify their trade, you know, to bring growth on their trade. For that assortments, WTO plays what roles? Important roles. So today in this video I have explained about what is WTO and what is the objective of WTO. Okay, thank you all of you.